When I say hacking, what comes to your mind instantaneously?
To the risk of sounding very dumb, all my hacking references come from TV.
Correct.
So I feel like this is how it goes now. Mm-hmm. Okay. So there is a target. Mm. And then a person who's the hacker is usually approached by like the glamorous lead.
Correct.
Who cannot be like the hacker individual who's
Correct.
Like wearing a sweatshirt and sitting in a dark room.
Correct.
And now in the dark room there are lots of screens and everything is like green code.
Correct.
Like that, you know, that access denied code, whatever.
Correct.
So all the green code is going on and this mm-hmm. person like furiously typing. And there's like the thing which goes like firewall 1 breached, firewall 2 breached, because they're like attacking something and like the walls are crumbling down and they're like going through something.
Correct.
And at some point like that side ka cyber security fights back. And like some dishoom is happening like in hacker mode. And wait, nah, it's not done.
Okay.
So like dishoom is happening in hacker mode. And then this guy's like, I can't stop them, but I can slow them down. And then he does some more like thing, and then like pop-ups come up from everywhere. And he's like, oh no, something is happening. And at least 3 times this access denied comes because like he's breaking into something. Then finally he breaks into it. And then the other side loses complete control. Matlab abhi udhar light off ho raha hai, ya fir camera turn ho ja raha hai, ya fir whatever
data chori ho raha hai.
Like whatever the reason for the hack was, is happening. That's the proper hacking
season. So actual hacking mein, there is no like, so there's no speed.
Oh.
So basically nothing is like super rushed. Like if you're hacking, you want to take your time to get through, you know.
Oh.
It's super slow. Plus once hacking starts, there's no stopping hacking.
Okay. But so you can't slow it down.
No, if you know hacking is happening, right?
Okay.
Max you can do is you can shut certain things off over again. But there's no slowing it. Either it's in or it's out. It's like a
So
computer.
How about this? If someone's hacking into my...
But it's a,
first of all, question.
Huh?
Does a person hack into your computer? Like, does it live inside the hardware?
Yeah.
Or are they hacking into, like, the software in it?
So, they can't really hack the hardware. Like, entering through software only. Code is software. Correct. So, it's basically that. Actually, more importantly, the point is... So thing is, when you gain access, you just gain access. There's no process.
Oh, there's no wall 1, wall 2.
No, it's inside, ghus gaye. So it's not like if somebody has made it in, they've made it in. Plus, most hacking is actually like really boring. It takes days. Like one of the biggest hacks that ever took place was in the Bank of Bangladesh. When North Korean hackers almost stole $1 billion. Because... Not because they didn't make the transfers, it was the Western countries' ke exchanges' ke systems that marked it as suspicious and canned them.
Damn.
Who held them for review and then they were cancelled. Because they were held for review because it was like, why is Bank of Bangladesh making these transactions? But transactions were made. And guess how it happened? They sent like a mass phishing email to everybody in the building. One person clicked on it. And it took months, hopping from one machine to the other.
Month-long enterprise to steal money.
Yeah, till it went where it went. And then it stayed there till they found the right time to execute that plan, which was over like a celebration over Ramzan, because they knew the 3 days the bank would be shut.
Damn.
So they executed on one day before that.
So it is, okay, so it took like months and months.
Correct.
Of planning.
Plus, most hacking is actually more hacking is more like phishing. They use
the word
phishing because basically you throw in a bait and you hope somebody catches it.
Please.
Correct. Yeah.
Correct.
And the weird thing is, so there's something known as a key logger. Do you know what a key logger is?
I've heard it in like people say these things. They say like firewall and they say encryption and they say key logger.
So the key logger is by far one of like the first of all.
In one. South Indian movie, I remember, like it was actually in Hindi,
right.
And I saw it on the bus, so I don't know any details.
Correct.
I just know that someone said that the keylogger is like a painter's address. Like, so if a hacker is trying to get into your system, he will leave his keylogger.
No, that's not
true. So then that's wrong.
Keylogger is essentially, basically whatever you type, it remembers. So you can gain access. So for example, in your...
Wow, that was very wrong.
So basically, if I put a keylogger on your phone, I know everything you have typed, including your
passwords. So that's how people get your passwords.
Yeah, easy access. Fun story here, I have actually used a keylogger on our own home computer. When I was in 12th, dad blocked access to the internet, so I installed a keylogger to get the password.
So you are a low-key hacker.
Low-key. But that is what hacking
literally
is.
Literally, like, the key and the key log. And then
but that's what most hacking is. It's not like that is considered basic hacking. Oh. First of all, to hack, you don't need, like, really complicated hacking skills. Like, this thing, this basic keylogger.
I have to say, like, all that, also it's hacking. Making me a little sad because I feel like there's so much drama associated with those scenes. Like, even, like, MI6 and, like, all these James Bondy movies.
Correct.
Like, when the hacking happens, it's like these huge orbs are trying to interact with each other and numbers
but
are going around them.
Even if,
it's, like such a beautiful UI.
Yeah, but there is no UI, though. Hackers just read code. So, actually, one part films get, it is a guy in a hoodie, but just going through like a lot of text. So basically, they can just read it like how we read like English.
Okay.
They can read the code.
Okay. So, and this, but he has to go through it carefully to find
it. They're just reading it and being like, okay, yahan pe kuch hai, yahan pe kuch
kar sakte hai.
Correct, haan, yahan pe ghuste hai. It's basically most, it's like being able to read a book, right?
Yeah.
It's like all of us are illiterate, hackers are literate. That's the way of thinking about it, you know? They can read code. So basically UI pata kya, jaise how to unpad people they use signs and symbols so that they can understand language.
Correct.
Right? Like if you don't know how to read and write,
yeah,
it's a sign of an apple.
Huh. Or like a cigarette with a cross in it. Like
correct.
Don't smoke it.
Correct. Yeah. But if you know how to read, it's just write don't smoke or APPLE.
Okay.
So hackers are essentially people who can just read it.
And so, we see all the signs, like the little like gear thing for settings and all that.
Correct.
They can just read it.
Correct. So they can just enter the software. So imagine that, but there is zero UI. They don't need a mouse pointer. They can just read machine code.
They don't need a mouse?
No, they just read the code. They're talking
that
directly to the machine.
Okay, that's crazy.
Yeah. And most of the time, to be honest, 90% of all hacking is essentially people just guessing your password.
That yes. I knew.
Correct.
And you know why I do that? Because
but
I
just say in a movie, it'd be very. I want to see a movie where they go, abhi main hack karta hai and wo uske Facebook
phone pe jaake.
Nahi, Facebook profile pe jaake stalk kar raha hai. Iske mummy ka naam kya hai? Mom's maiden name is there. Wo sab hai. Jaake
exactly.
He goes to forgot password and just enters the details through the social network.
And you're like, done. Hacking over.
Hacking over. Because that's accurate. That's exactly what a hacker would do.
That's how I was taught like the hard way. Basically, once by college, this cybersecurity expert came and he walked into the class and everyone was pretty excited because we had no idea what it is. And he was like, okay, so I want to start the class on a really good note. Aaj kiska birthday? I have a special gift for you guys. And obviously, jiska bhi birthday, I was like, yeah, me, I got a gift. And the person, he's like, okay, cool, the three of you, what's your name? He's like, I know your name and I know your birthday. Essentially, your life is an open book to me. I can hack you now. Okay. And everyone became so quiet. They're like, oh shit, that is very accurate.
Because also I feel, so there's another thing people say that why hacking is so over the top in movies, just like how violence is over the top in movies, it's supposed to be fun. Right.
Yeah,
nobody wants to see realistic violence in movies, right?
Correct.
That's
like scarring.
Scarring. Aisa, chidri, you're like, in the theater. Nobody wants.
I didn't sign up for this.
Yeah, aisa,
I went for Abbas Mastan movie.
Correct.
Why is this happening?
Is the violence so anatomically correct? I don't want anatomically correct violence. हाँ ना उसको थप्पड़ मारता है उसके चित्रे चित्रे उड़ रहे हैं ऐसा नहीं you don't want ना इसका ऐसा his skeletal structure being shown same way you don't want that kind of realism in hacking also
because you'll just be like the 4-hour movie में 1-hour will be hacking scene where nothing happens
yeah and you don't want to be also
or it can be a time lapse
yeah or it can also be yeah you know that's a good idea
it can be a montage
I think few movies have used it
yeah
but on the other hand also you don't want to give real hacking tips to people. Yeah, it's like you don't want to be so accurate that people go, hey, ye to main kar sakta.
I can earn lots of money at home comfort of my home.
After certain movies, some people have to put out advisories because they use real software. Like after Matrix Reloaded, the government of like UK or whatever put out an advisory saying, don't try and use this hacking because if we catch you doing this,
you'll go to
jail. Aisa karke, aisa time pass ke liye bhi nahi kar rahe.
Wow, I didn't know Matrix was so accurate when it came to hacking because the rest of Matrix is like pretty like out there.
To be honest, the coding parts and this thing, they really went into the depth for it to make sense.
So for it to feel that real.
So if you look at Matrix ke coders, they have no UI.
Yeah, they don't. I remember
They're working on consoles. So there are multiple screens and they're reading the code. And वो बंदा बोलता भी है the way I can read this code, I can tell you what's happening as though I'm seeing it.
Correct.
So they actually go to the distance and explain this pattern in the movie. So that part of Matrix, overall concept of that way was pretty realistic. Like it's a fantasy fiction with a high level of like realism.
That's what makes it a good fantasy fiction.
Exactly. Correct, yeah. And it's so also they used tools that don't exist in programming, but the effects and all the everything else was real. That's pretty cool. So my point is, how to be safe in real life?
Don't
is,
open attachments.
No, just treat internet files like you treat food. ठीक है कोई रास्ते में random इधर को खाना दे रहा है नहीं लेने का. Don't take food from strangers. Don't take files from strangers. Treat your file and
like food. That's a nice place to wrap this up.
Cool. Hey man, this is Prakup Panda. We discuss this and so much more in our podcast where we actually discuss films and the cyber law aspect of it.
Yeah.
And see that where you can, how, today we talked about how you can hack that could get you in jail, how badly you will be in jail. We discussed in our podcast. Do check it out.
Yeah, check it out. Because it'll be super fun.
Correct. We have new episodes out every week. So don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment if you have ever hacked in your life.
Yep.